Live from Atlanta, 11Alive News at 11:30 starts now.
Day two of possible severe storms throughout the metro today. This is a live look from our 11Alive Thunder Truck. This hour going 75 north in Cobb County. No rain coming down on the windshield yet, but less than an hour ago, the National Weather Service issued a severe thunderstorm watch for most of North Georgia until 5 p.m. This second round comes less than 24 hours after an EF1 tornado touched down, wreaking havoc on Douglas County and Southwest Atlanta. These are images out of Fulton County after the storm passed yesterday. You can see buildings were heavily damaged, leaving behind significant amounts of debris. That EF1 tornado claimed a life in Douglasville yesterday when a tree fell on the man's car while he was driving. Coming up, we learn more about Scott Hudson and the community that adored him. But first, we are preparing for this second round of severe storms. Meteorologist Chesley McNeil has been tracking it all morning long. Chesley, what do we need to be ready for today?
Well, mainly those severe thunderstorms that could produce winds up to about 60 miles per hour. That's going to be our major threat, but also isolated tornadoes similar to what we saw just yesterday. We had them popping up earlier yesterday. We haven't seen any as of yet, but the storm system is just now starting to move into our state, mainly up here to the far northwestern corner of the state is where you're going to find that. Right now, we do have a severe thunderstorm warning. You see it for parts of Whitfield County into Murray County as well. This is where we're looking at winds up to about 60 miles per hour with a little bit of hail in some of these storms and producing a lot of lightning here. This is set to expire around 12 o'clock. We just had one for northern parts of Floyd County, but that expired at 11:30. And so now we're just dealing with this one. Going to continue to push over toward the east at about 55 miles per hour. So places like Higdon and Fanning County, also over toward Gilbert County, we'll start to see these, or at least hear these thunderstorms making it their way towards you, and the wind starting to pick up here probably in the next 20-25 minutes or so. And then back off to the west, you can see that line of showers and thunderstorms. Look at the numerous lightning strikes associated with it. There are a couple of severe thunderstorm warnings associated with that as well. That's going to continue to push to the east and down to the southeast. So I think around the noontime, that's when we'll start to see it a little bit closer to the city of Atlanta, but our northernmost counties right now experiencing some of that heavy rain and those thunderstorms. We do have a severe thunderstorm watch in effect, which means we're watching for the potential of severe thunderstorms to pop up in the area for much of North Georgia. As you can see, this will last until 5 o'clock this afternoon. Slight risk for severe weather over much of our area once again, but notice down here to the south and west of the city of Atlanta, our westernmost counties under at level 3 threat, which is an enhanced risk for severe weather. That's where we could see some of those isolated tornadoes, but I'd say in and around this area is where that is mostly possible, especially as we head into the afternoon. Here's some timing on it right now. You see the storms up to the far northwest that will make its way down toward Atlanta, over toward Athens around the 2 o'clock hour this afternoon, and then start to sink a little bit further down to the south. Notice we catch a brief break. We'll watch for another round, which right now on our particular model seems to be breaking down before it makes its way in. So we'll have to another area that we'll have to watch later on this afternoon and into tonight. We'll continue to monitor it. In the meantime, go ahead and download our 11Alive app to make sure that you get all the latest alerts that you need to keep your family safe for this afternoon. Got a QR code right there that just popped on the screen. Just put your phone up there, put it on photo. Just set it there, right there to that QR code, and it'll start to download it for you and get all the alerts right there on your phone. Christy, back to you.
All right. Thank you, Chesley. New today, we're learning more about the man killed yesterday when a tree fell on his car during the storm. Friends identified him as Scott Hudson. It happened just 3 minutes away from his family-owned restaurant. Dozens of people stopped by that restaurant, Hudson's Hickory House, to pay their respects yesterday. Hope Ford spoke with some of his closest longtime friends who say the community is not ready to say goodbye.
We've been coming here every Friday night for better part of 30 years.
Jeff Posey loves Hudson's Hickory House, but it's not just for the food. It's for his friend, the owner, Scott Hudson, who always greeted Jeff when he walked in.
It will be something that I'm looking for when I walk in the door for a long time.
Friends say Scott died after a tree fell on his car during a storm in Douglasville. Now his family-owned restaurant, serving the community for 50 years, serves as a memorial, with longtime customers paying their respects.
I think it's going to feel empty. Without that presence, without that love, without that care in the room.
Ask anyone and they'll tell you Scott was more than a businessman. An employee of 24 years tells us if someone couldn't pay for their food, they ate for free. And Scott would often pay down student lunch debts.
He was always around for all of us. When we really needed something, we could just call him.
Because he was just good to everybody. The railroad track being right here, years ago, when the trains would come by, they would call here from 30 minutes out. and give their order. And Scott would walk across that street with a box of food and hold it up as they went, and they grab it as they went by.
Jeff called Scott part of his family and says it broke his heart to visit Scott's daughter just hours after his death.
It's rough. They don't know how to feel right now. All pretty numb.
Scott leaves behind his daughter, his father, Buford, who opened the restaurant back in 1971, and a brother and a sister. Yesterday's storms claimed a second life in Bonaire. According to the Houston County Emergency Management Agency, 55-year-old Carla Harris was killed when a tree fell on her home. Her husband called 911 just after 4:30 in the afternoon. Officials believe the tree fell because of high winds up to 50 to 60 miles per hour. The Red Cross, it will now be assisting that family. If the rain and the wind wasn't bad enough yesterday, then a sinkhole appeared. Neighbors and crews say crews have been working for about a month on a watershed project in that area. This is on Whitmore Drive in northwest Atlanta, where this giant hole opened up. We're told no work has been done on the hole yet, and neighbors are worried about what comes next with more rain coming today. We have reached out to the city and are still waiting for a comment. For the latest weather updates in your area, download the 11Alive app. You know you always have your phone with us, so here you can turn on notifications, customize them for your area, and be alerted when you need to take cover. This morning, Atlanta's mayor and interim police chief are answering questions about the rise in gun violence and the city's efforts to curb it. 11Alive's Tracy A. McPeer was just at a press conference with them. Tracy, the mayor started by talking off about the APD leadership moving forward. What did she say?
Well, the mayor is recommending that interim police chief Rodney Bryant be named permanent chief, citing his history and relationship with the department and the city of Atlanta. But of course, the main focus was on crime.
We have one of the best homicide investigating unit in this country. We do a phenomenal job of finding people that commit violent acts in our city.
Between Thursday and Sunday, there were 22 shootings and 4 people were killed. That includes Diamond Johnson, a 15-year-old girl who was killed Saturday while standing with a group of teens near Maynard Jackson High School and a Waffle House restaurant on Glenwood Avenue in southeast Atlanta. Now, last night, police released photos of 3 cars they are looking for in connection with that case. Now, another issue they addressed today was the large number of guns in the hands of criminals. They talked about how they are working with the ATF and working with other agencies across jurisdictional lines to try to cut down on that. They also urge the public to please keep the guns out of your cars so they can't be stolen.
All right, something the public can do. Thank you, Tracy. Staying in Fulton County now, Atlanta police have released new video in a homicide investigation. Police say the video you're seeing right now is from the early morning of December 1st. Officers say a man was shot inside a home on Rocky Ford Road. 2 unidentified suspects can be seen running from the location. If you know anything about this, call police. There's a number of health benefits to breastfeeding for both mom and baby, but can COVID antibodies also be passed from mother to child? Our experts verify the vaccine's impact on nursing mothers and their newborns.
Days where we're speaking at you. On Morning Rush, we're speaking with you.
So connect with us. Talk to us.
Think of it as a conversation.
Morning Rush weekdays, 5 to 7 on 11Alive.
Quick, open your phone camera right now, aim it at the screen to download 11Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Morning news should be informative and fun.
Yeah, and we do that here on Morning Rush with Verify, Connect the Dots, Why Guy, and more.
We love learning about new things and sharing them with you.
We make the news make sense.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11Alive.
The Negro people had to leave. They were told to get out.
White only, no black!
1912, all but one issue has been erased.
We haven't had none up here since the first of the century.
What's the importance of making sure this history isn't erased?
So that it doesn't happen again.
Is your morning routine feeling a little routine?
Then mix it up. Morning Rush is different.
It's the fast-paced news you need.
With all the energy of your morning coffee.
Come see the difference on Morning Rush weekdays on 11 Alive.
Weather can't run from the all-new 11 Alive Thunder Truck, a mobile weather center with the power and speed to chase down the strongest storms and bring you on-the-ground conditions. The 11 Alive Thunder Truck, sponsored by Landmark Dodge.
Here in Atlanta, bad weather means bad traffic. A few drops of rain could destroy a commute. But that's where my man Crash Clark comes in. I go street level, he goes next level. Together, we make sure you get to work on time. Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive. Hey, quick, open up your phone camera right now. Aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you right to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Atlanta roads are my thing. ITP, OTP, Ponce, Piedmont, all the peach trees. Combined with Chesley's street level forecast, that's a lot of tech and experience to help your commute.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
We're quite the combo.
No appointment, no problem. People in Fulton County can now walk up to vaccination locations and get their Pfizer COVID-19 vaccines. It's happening at the Georgia International Convention Center in College Park and the vaccination site on North Point Parkway in Alpharetta. Vaccines will be available on a first-come, first-served basis from 10:30 in the morning until 3 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday. The Mercedes-Benz Stadium will continue to accept walk-ups and appointments through June 15th. And a major breakthrough in the fight against COVID, especially in children ahead of the upcoming school year. The FDA is expected to authorize Pfizer shot for a younger age group by early next week. The pharmaceutical giant has applied for emergency use authorization for its vaccine in kids 12 through 15. At the end of March, the company said a clinical trial involving more than 2,200 12 to 15-year-olds showed the vaccine's efficacy to be 100%. Next up, the vaccine or the Federal Vaccine Advisory Committee will then meet to discuss whether to recommend it or not. Then the FDA will decide whether to take action. With vaccines going into arms, people here in Georgia and across the country are finally getting a glimpse at our new normal. What exactly will that look like? And will we ever truly reach herd immunity? Paolo Soro spoke to a risk crisis expert who says he believes our new normal might be here sooner than we expect.
That new normal could look different for everyone.
We need to be washing our hands. We should have been doing that in the first place. Wearing our mask if we're in crowds.
What's the point of living if you're scared of dying? I mean, you might as well live. You live like to the fullest at this point.
But ask Daniel Richards with Global Rescue, and he'll say,
we are weeks, not months away from having the opportunity to do that.
The CEO of the company that provides risk crisis management services around the world says that by the end of this month, everyone who wants to get the COVID-19 vaccine should be able to, getting us closer to our new normal.
It means we can be inside together without masks. We can relax social distancing requirements. We can go to the movies. We can get on airplanes. We can do all kinds of things domestically that we weren't doing during the pandemic.
Richard says it's not realistic to put a percentage on the population that needs to be vaccinated to reach herd immunity. He says that scientists are already developing therapeutics to help manage COVID-19 instead of focusing on getting rid of it.
The likelihood that we eradicate COVID is not very high, at least not in the near term. But it doesn't mean that we can't drive it into the shadows so that there are really only small corners of the world where people really suffer from.
Richard says that in the future, he expects pills to be the new form of vaccinations as scientists work to develop new medicine to treat and cure COVID-19.
It's likely that those drugs will be approved over the next few months. I think the future is very bright, and it's going to be here sooner than I think we all expect.
I don't think anything will ever go back to normal.
Life is not life without risk.
For more on the vaccine in Georgia, just text the word vaccine to 404-885-7600. We'll send you a link straight to your phone. Chesley, over to you, my friend.
All right. Thanks a lot, Christy. Let's take a look at what's going on outside around us. We told you that there would be another round of severe weather pushing into the forecast area, and we're seeing that as we speak. Mainly up to the north right now is where you're going to find that. This red box that you see here, this jagged box, that is a tornado watch, but that's for Alabama. That has not been extended into our state. We do have a severe thunderstorm watch that's in effect. We'll get to that in just a few minutes. We do have one warning that's out there right now. This is a severe thunderstorm warning up here to the far north, as you can see. In fact, we'll zoom in on this a little bit. It is set to expire right around 12:30. 12:30 is when that's set to expire. Moving up toward the northeast at about 55 miles per hour, so that would place this cluster of thunderstorms over toward Higdon right at noon. Blue Ridge, about 7 minutes after noon. Could make it up toward Mineral Bluff right around 12:10. And so we'll continue to watch that. Now, here's the edge of that watch, or the warning box, rather, right bumping up against Fanning and Gilmer County. We'll see if they will continue that. Right now, again, it's set to expire around 12 o'clock, so we'll continue to watch it. But then there's more thunderstorms back off to our west, as you can see. Look at the energy associated with this. All these lightning strikes associated with these thunderstorms will continue to push a little bit further down to the south and into our state. So the Rome area right now, just check the camera there. I haven't even seen a raindrop yet, but it's coming your way. Probably within the next 10 minutes or so, you'll start to see the rain, and certainly you're already hearing the thunder from those lightning strikes back off to your north and west. It will continue to push down toward the city of Atlanta and probably arrive here between 1 and 2 o'clock this afternoon. The severe thunderstorm watch will last until 5 o'clock. That's for much of North Georgia, as you can see, all our highlighted counties here. That means we're watching for the potential for severe thunderstorms to pop up. When we talk about severe thunderstorms, that means thunderstorms capable of producing winds up to 60 or 70 miles per hour. Hail would be associated with a few of those, but really those gusty winds is what we really will be concerned about. And an isolated tornado can pop up. We saw that yesterday, and certainly it could pop up again today. The other threat would be that very heavy rain that's out there. You can see much of the same area under a flash flood watch. This will last until 2 a.m. on Wednesday, as we'll continue to see rounds of rain pushing into the forecast area. And we already had some very heavy rain just yesterday, so the ground already saturated, so that could lead to more flooding in the forecast area. Tracking a front that's back off to the west of us, you can see the thunderstorms out ahead of this. That's what we're going to deal with, which would be the first round. As the front gets a little closer, we'll see another round try to make it into the forecast area later on this afternoon. We'll say late afternoon into the evening. Notice this wide area of tan here, which stretches from Louisiana right on through Mississippi, Alabama, and stretches into our state. That is a level 3 threat for severe weather. All right, an enhanced risk for severe weather that includes our west and southwestern counties. So we'll be watching for that. Isolated tornadoes certainly possible in that area, but I'd also say in and around that area where we have the level 2 threat from Rome, Atlanta, over to Athens, Augusta. That's where we can see some isolated tornadoes as well, but we're mainly concerned about those damaging winds from those thunderstorms that happen to move into the forecast area, and then it gets a little bit weaker once it gets up to the north and east. Once again, the flood watch remains in effect as well. Here it is, our forecast track model. You can follow along with me with the time right there at the top of the screen. Shows those storms making its way down toward Atlanta and a little bit south once we get to 1, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We'll continue to fade further down to the south once we get toward the 5 o'clock hour. And notice how we're catching a brief break up here to the north, expecting another round to start to push toward our area. Now, our model saying that area will weaken a bit, mainly thanks to the thunderstorms that have already pushed through. We'll watch to see if that's the case. Some of those could hold together and affect our westernmost counties. But right now, according to our model, that starts to weaken before it moves in. So that's a bit of some good news for us this afternoon. And then we'll watch for the clouds to be around right on through the overnight going into Wednesday morning. A few sprinkles in the morning, but by the afternoon, notice how we clear it out, and we'll get the sunshine back in here as we head toward the end of the work week. So that's some good news for us as well. But today we need to be weather ready. Make sure that you download our 11Alive app. We're going to throw up the QR code real quick, put it on the screen there. You can point your phone, put it on your camera, point your phone right at that QR code, and it'll download it for you. Get all the alerts right there on your phone. Be weather prepared this afternoon. Christy, back to you.
That's how I get my alerts. Thanks, Chesley. The American College of OBGYNs recommends that COVID-19 vaccines be offered to mothers who are breastfeeding. And now many online are asking if breastfeeding mothers who are vaccinated can pass antibodies through their breast milk. But what do we know about lactating mothers and the COVID-19 vaccine? Our Verify team is asking the experts.
Verify exists to get you the vetted facts about what you read online. And you've probably heard this one, that breastfeeding mothers who are vaccinated for COVID-19 can pass antibodies through their breast milk. So we're tackling this claim in two parts, with some help from our sources, three breast milk experts, along with some studies on the subject. First, here's question one.
Are there SARS-CoV-2 specific antibodies in human milk? Can we say that with confidence? Yes. Absolutely.
Several studies have found this result already, although we should note that they're not all peer-reviewed just yet.
Take that with a grain of salt.
But from the studies that have come out, there's robust antibody response, more so after vaccination and after natural infection and breast milk.
They have only confirmed our feeling that what we would have predicted is that A, it would be safe, and B, there would be transfer of antibodies, and that's what we're seeing in the preliminary data.
So that brings us to our next question. Is there any evidence that these antibodies can protect infants? And at this point, we just don't know for sure. Although two out of our three experts think the answer could be yes, based on what they already know about the medicinal properties of breast milk.
What is the degree of protection? You know, how long does it last? Those are scientific questions that we should explore. But I think it's safe to say that there will be some degree of protection.
If there's something you want us to verify, send us an email. You can also reach out to us on Twitter or on our 11 Alive Facebook page. It's 11:50 right now. Olympic gold, often a solo battle, as much as it is a team effort. Coming up, this year's Olympians reflect on how much they value their teammates as they prepare for the Summer Olympics in Tokyo.
So connect with us. Talk to us.
Think of it as a conversation.
Morning Rush weekdays, 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
Quick, open your phone camera right now, aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Morning news should be informative and fun.
Yeah, and we do that here on Morning Rush with Verify, Connect the Dots, Why Guy, and more.
We love learning about new things and sharing them with you.
We make the news make sense.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
The Negro people had to leave. They were told to get out.
White only, no black!
1912, all but one issue has been erased.
We haven't had none up here since the first of the century.
What's the importance of making sure this history isn't erased?
So that it doesn't happen again.
Is your morning routine feeling a little routine?
Then mix it up. Morning Rush is different.
It's the fast-paced news you need.
With all the energy of your morning coffee. Come see the difference on Morning Rush weekdays on 11 Alive.
Weather can't run from the all-new 11 Alive Thunder Truck, a mobile weather center with the power and speed to chase down the strongest storms and bring you on-the-ground conditions. The 11 Alive Thunder Truck, sponsored by Landmark Dodge.
Here in Atlanta, bad weather means bad traffic. A few drops of rain could destroy a commute. But that's where my man Crash Clark comes in. I go street level, he goes next level. Together, we make sure you get to work on time. Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive. Hey, quick, open up your phone camera right now. Aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you right to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Atlanta roads are my thing. ITP, OTP, Ponce, Piedmont, all the peach trees. Combined with Chesley's street level forecast, that's a lot of tech and experience to help your commute.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
We're quite the combo.
Weather changes can make or break your day. That's why the 11 Alive Storm Trackers are always watching what's coming next.
Winning an Olympic medal can be a long, arduous, sometimes solitary battle, but most any Olympian will admit it wouldn't mean nearly as much if they didn't have the teammates to do it with and for.
I wouldn't do this sport if I had to swim by myself. I'd go crazy. I need people around me who are going to hold me accountable. And, you know, I want to do the same for them. I want to hold them accountable.
Dressel's cheering him on, trying to get his sixth gold medal of these championships. Simone Manuel with 10 meters left.
It is a family.
To the wall it'll be. be the United States with a new world record.
Being a part of a team is the most magical thing that you can be a part of.
It's like a family because nobody else in the world quite understands the dynamic or everything that goes on, unlike your teammates do.
You know, we're all a family. We all have one common goal that we wanted to uphold, and that's what brings us all together.
I'm close with everyone on the team. Everyone's got each other's back. I mean, at the end of the day, you do it for the guy right next to you.
Of course, you're fighting for the Olympic dream and the Olympic gold medal, but to be honest, it wouldn't mean anything if you weren't on the podium with those women. That's what it's about.
Informative and fun.
Yeah, and we do that here on Morning Rush with Verify, Connect the Dots, Why Guy, and more.
We love learning about new things and sharing them with you.
We make the news make sense.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
The Negro people had to leave. They were told to get out.
White only, no black!
1912, all but one issue has been erased.
We haven't had none up here since the first of the century.
What's the importance of making sure this history isn't erased?
So that it doesn't happen again.
Is your morning routine feeling a little routine?
Then mix it up. Morning Rush is different.
It's the fast-paced news you need.
With all the energy of your morning coffee.
Come see the difference on Morning Rush, weekdays on 11 Alive.
Weather can't run from the all-new 11 Alive Thunder Truck, a mobile weather center with the power and speed to chase down the strongest storms and bring you on-the-ground conditions. The 11 Alive Thunder Truck, sponsored by Landmark Dodge.
Here in Atlanta, bad weather means bad traffic. A few drops of rain could destroy a commute. But that's where my man Crash Clark comes in. I go street level, he goes next level. Together, we make sure you get to work on time. Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive. Hey, quick, open up your phone camera right now. Aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you right to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Atlanta roads are my thing. ITP, OTP, Ponce, Piedmont, all the peach trees. Combined with Chesley's street level forecast, that's a lot of tech and experience to help your commute.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
We're quite the combo.
Weather changes can make or break your day. That's why the 11 Alive Storm Trackers are always watching what's coming next, delivering accessible and accurate forecasts that prepare you, not scare you. For Storm Trackers, only on 11 Alive.
COVID-19 is still spreading in Georgia. Now get facts, not fear, at 11alive.com/COVID numbers. Track cases by county using our interactive map and get the latest health department data. Visit 11alive.com/COVID numbers. Eleven Alive is where Atlanta speaks, and Morning Rush insider Janet reached out to tell us about the good things happening in Roswell, like local efforts to address food insecurity. So we sent our Eliza Lucas to learn more about a special little pantry. It's this morning's Hero Central.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
We keep baby food and baby needs up at the top. And
the little free pantry sits on this corner in Roswell. A little lifeline for neighbors in need.
I stock the pantry 2 to 3 times a day, depending on, you know, how busy it is.
Maya Pounds and her husband built and maintained the free pantry, hoping to help those struggling during the pandemic.
It's been a really cool thing to see so many people come together. People will drop off donations just of food and diapers and toiletries and those kinds of things. And we have a lot of people that will come throughout the day and grab what they need.
A chef and baker, Maya's goal for the pantry rooted in her own passion for food.
Food insecurity is something that I try to use my gifts to, you know, to help other people. I've been in both sides of the situation. You know, I've been the person in need and I have been the person that's able to give.
Word of the Little Free Pantry has spread via social media, the community keeping it stocked. Maya says these shelves aren't meant to be a long-term solution, but she hopes the Little Free Pantry can fill the gap for anyone experiencing temporary hardship.
You could be completely fine and have, you know, money for groceries one week and then the next week you don't. Everybody's situation is unique. It's not meant to sustain someone long term. You know, there's amazing organizations for that. It's just people helping people, neighbors helping neighbors.
Live from Atlanta, 11 Alive News at noon starts now.
Day two of possible severe weather and storms to look for today throughout the metro. This is a live look from our 11 Alive Thunder Truck this hour. You can see the rain on the windshield. It is starting to come down. The Thunder Truck is heading north on I-75 going towards Bartow County right now. About an hour ago, the National Weather Service issued a severe thunderstorm watch for most of North Georgia until 5 p.m. This second round of storms comes less than 24 hours after an EF1 tornado touched down near Metro Atlanta yesterday, wreaking havoc on Douglas County and Southwest Atlanta. A lot of damage there. These are images out of Fulton County after the storm passed. You can see buildings heavily damaged and leaving behind significant amounts of debris. The EF1 tornado claimed a life in Douglasville yesterday when a tree fell on the man's car while he was driving. Coming up, we learn more about Scott Hudson and the community that just adored him. But first, we are preparing for that second wave of severe storms, and meteorologist Chesley McNeil has been tracking it all morning long for us. Chesley, what do we need to be ready for today and when?
Well, we have to be ready for very strong winds. We have to also be ready for isolated tornadoes, and that could be around right on through this afternoon. We have it in our northwestern counties right now. Thunderstorms. We had a severe thunderstorm warning that was up here to the north that has expired right at noon. And so now as it moves into places like over toward Fanning and Gilmer counties now, it's weakening somewhat in strength. And so the winds aren't up to the severe category, but still looking at winds maybe up to 40, 45 miles per hour. Numerous lightning strikes associated with these thunderstorms as well. That extends all the way back down into Calhoun, right along 75 here, I-75. And then look at those thunderstorms back off to the west of us over towards Somerville right now. Numerous lightning strikes associated with that. Been looking at the Rome camera there, and you can see here, a live look at it, no raindrops at all. But you can see those clouds starting to look a little bit more ominous. I'm sure folks out here are thinking, uh-oh, time to get inside, time to seek shelter. And that would be a good idea if you're up in Rome right now watching. There you go. Let's better look at it right there. You can see just to the north where you have the numerous thunderstorms, and off to the west, there's more, and that certainly is headed towards you. So probably within the next 15 minutes or so, those storms are going to be right down on you with some pretty gusty winds. Again, not severe yet, but we'll be watching for that, of course. And you can see the numerous thunderstorms that extend all the way back into Gadsden, over and toward Alabama, all that making its way down toward us. Showing some signs of weakening, which is good news for us as it continues to push further off toward the east. So something that we'll be watching for as we head through the rest of the afternoon. In fact, speaking of a watch, there is a severe thunderstorm watch in effect until 5 o'clock. That means we're watching for the potential for severe thunderstorms to form. Severe thunderstorms produce winds up to about 60 miles per hour. Hail associated with those as well, and you can't rule out an isolated tornado popping up. We saw that just yesterday, so certainly that could happen today. We are under that slight risk for severe weather, just like we were yesterday, but the difference here is that down to the south and to the west of us, we have a level 3, which is an enhanced risk for severe weather, which is an increased level 4 isolated tornadoes to pop up. We'll keep you updated right here all day long. Of course, you can download our 11Alive app. That'll give you alerts right there on your phone. There's a QR code to just pop up on the screen. If you point your camera right there at that code, it'll download it for you. I'll give you 2 more seconds for that, and we'll pop it up again in the full forecast coming up. Christy, back to you.
Right now, the National Weather Service is in South Fulton surveying the damage left behind from yesterday's storms. 11Alive Latasha Givens is on the ground in South Fulton for us right now, where there is a lot of damage. Latasha, I drove through there this morning and it was evident there was still a lot of debris on the ground. What are you seeing? All right, it looks like we don't have audio from Latasha, but you can see those branches and trees down, still a lot of debris down there. We'll see if we can get her audio back for us, but as I drove through South Fulton this morning, still a lot of trees down, a lot of people cleaning up this morning and getting ready now for round two. All right, new today, we are learning more about the man killed when a tree fell on his car during the storm. Friends identified him as Scott Hudson. It happened just 3 minutes away from his family-owned restaurant. Yesterday, dozens of people stopped by his restaurant, Hudson's Hickory House, to pay their respects. Hope Ford spoke with some of his closest, longtime friends who say this community is not ready to say goodbye.
We've been coming here every Friday night for better part of 30 years.
Jeff Posey loves Hudson's Hickory House, but it's not just for the food. It's for his friend, the owner, Scott Hudson, who always greeted Jeff when he walked in.
It will be something that I'm looking for when I walk in the door for a long time.
Friends say Scott died after a tree fell on his car during a storm in Douglasville. Now his family-owned restaurant, serving the community for 50 years, serves as a memorial, with longtime customers paying their respects.
I think it's going to feel empty. Without that presence, without that love, without that care in the room.
Ask anyone and they'll tell you Scott was more than a businessman. An employee of 24 years tells us if someone couldn't pay for their food, they ate for free. And Scott would often pay down student lunch debts.
He was always around for all of us. When we really needed something, we could just call him.
Because he was just good to everybody. The railroad track being right here. Years ago, when the trains would come by, they would call here from 30 minutes out and give their order, and Scott would walk across that street with a box of food and hold it up as they went, and they grab it as they went by.
Jeff called Scott part of his family and says it broke his heart to visit Scott's daughter just hours after his death.
It's rough. They don't know how to feel right now. All pretty numb.
Scott leaves behind his daughter, his father, Buford, who opened the restaurant in 1971, and a brother and a sister. Yesterday's storms claimed a second life in Bonaire. According to the Houston County Emergency Management Agency, 55-year-old Carla Harris was killed when a tree fell on her home. Her husband called 911 just after 4:30 in the afternoon. Officials believe the tree fell because of high winds up to 50 to 60 miles per hour. The Red Cross says it will be assisting the family. If the rain and wind wasn't bad enough yesterday, a sinkhole appeared. Neighbors say crews have been working for about a month now on a watershed project in the area. This is on Whitmore Drive in Northwest Atlanta, where this giant hole just opened up. We're told no work has been done on the sinkhole, and neighbors are now worried about what comes next with more rain in the forecast today. We have reached out to the city. We are still waiting for a comment. Right now, the National Weather Service is in South Fulton surveying the damage left behind from yesterday's storms. Let's go back out to Latasha Givens. We have her mic now. Latasha, show us what you're seeing out there.
Okay, Christy, I'm going to give you a 360 view. We're off of South Fulton Boulevard near Riverside. And if you look, you can see dozens of trees just toppled over, pulled from the roots. You can also see power lines, and not just the power lines knocked down, but you can see several parts of those power lines. And if you walk over here, you see mounds of trees just taller than I am, and even some that are still falling through the fence that look like those can hit the ground at any moment. And across the street here in this industrial park, that's where the National Weather Service was about 30 minutes ago. They came to survey the damage. Now, what's interesting is as you drive to this area, you don't see much damage. But once you get to this business strip, you see trees everywhere. You see parts of roofs toppled over. Our next stop is going to be on New Hope Road near Cascade. That's where the National Weather Center is now. And we're told there's more damage over there. Christy, back to you.
Yeah, you can hear the leaf blower going, probably some more chainsaws today as people continue to clean up. Thanks, Latasha. For the latest weather updates in your area, download the 11 Alive News app and be sure to turn on notifications. You can customize them for your specific area. This morning, Atlanta's mayor and interim police chief are answering questions about the rise in gun violence and the city's efforts to curb it. 11 Alive's Tracy A. McPeer was at a press conference with them in the last half hour. And Tracy, the mayor started off by talking about APD leadership.
she did, the mayor is recommending that interim police chief Rodney Bryant be named permanent chief, citing his relationship and history with the department as well as the city of Atlanta. But of course, the main focus was the rise in violent crime. Just this last week, there were 22 shootings and 4 people killed. That's between Thursday and Sunday. That includes Diamond Johnson, a 15-year-old girl who was killed Saturday while standing with a group of teens near Maynard Jackson High School and a Waffle House restaurant on Glenwood Avenue in Southeast Atlanta. Last night, police released photos of 3 cars they are looking for in connection with that case. Now, another issue that they addressed is the large amount of guns in the hands of criminals. They talked about how they are working with ATF and other jurisdictions across jurisdictional lines to try to cut down on that. One thing that they did recommend was to keep guns out of your car. That way, they can't be stolen.
All right, that's one thing the public can do. Thank you, Tracy. 12:09 right now. There is a number of health benefits to breastfeeding for both mom and baby, but can COVID antibodies also be passed from mother to child? Our experts verify the vaccine's impact on nursing mothers and their newborns.
COVID-19 is still spreading in Georgia. Now get facts, not fear, at 11alive.com/COVID numbers. Track cases by county using our interactive map and get the latest health department data. Visit 11alive.com/COVID numbers.
Health experts fear we're just at the start of another surge.
Residents here are some of the first seniors to get the vaccine.
This epidemic can come to an end.
We do have a flash flood warning that just popped up here.
And the fallout of this is just beginning.
The bigger questions are the longer legal ramifications.
Morning news should be both informative and fun.
Gone are the days where we're speaking at you. On Morning Rush, we're speaking with you.
So connect with us. Talk to us.
Think of it as a conversation.
Morning Rush weekdays, 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
Quick, open your phone camera right now, aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Morning news should be informative and fun.
Yeah, and we do that here on Morning Rush with Verify, Connect the Dots, Why Guy, and more.
We love learning about new things and sharing them with you.
We make the news make sense.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
The Negro people had to leave. They were told to get out.
White only, no black!
1912, all but one issue has been erased.
We haven't had none up here since the first of the century.
What's the importance of making sure this history isn't erased?
So that it doesn't happen again.
Is your morning routine feeling a little routine?
Then mix it up. Morning Rush is different.
It's the fast-paced news you need.
With all the energy of your morning coffee.
Come see the difference on Morning Rush weekdays on 11 Alive.
Weather can't run from the all-new 11 Alive Thunder Truck, a mobile weather center with the power and speed to chase down the strongest storms and bring you on-the-ground conditions. The 11 Alive Thunder Truck, sponsored by Landmark Dodge.
Here in Atlanta, bad weather means bad traffic. A few drops of rain could destroy a community.
No appointment, no problem. People in Fulton County can now walk up to vaccination locations and get their Pfizer COVID-19 vaccines. It's happening at the Georgia International Convention Center in College Park and the vaccination site on North Point Parkway in Alpharetta. Vaccines will be available daily on a first-come, first-served basis from 10:30 in the morning until 3 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday. The Mercedes-Benz Stadium will continue to accept walk-ups and appointments through June 15th. And with vaccines going into arms, people here in Georgia and across the country are finally getting a glimpse at our new normal. What exactly will that look like, and will we ever truly reach herd immunity? Well, Paolo Soro spoke to a risk crisis expert who says he believes our new normal might be here sooner than we expect.
That new normal could look different for everyone.
We need to be washing our hands. We should have been doing that in the first place.
wearing our mask, if we're in crowds.
What's the point of living if you're scared of dying? I mean, you might as well live, you live like to the fullest at this point.
But ask Daniel Richards with Global Rescue and he'll say,
we are weeks, not months away from having the opportunity to do that.
The CEO of the company that provides risk crisis management services around the world says that by the end of this month, everyone who wants to get the COVID-19 vaccine should be able to, getting us closer to our new normal.
It means we can be inside together without masks. We can relax social distancing requirements. We can go to the movies. We can get on airplanes. We can do all kinds of things domestically that we weren't doing during the pandemic.
Richard says it's not realistic to put a percentage on the population that needs to be vaccinated to reach herd immunity. He says that scientists are already developing therapeutics to help manage COVID-19 instead of focusing on getting rid of it.
The likelihood that we eradicate COVID is not very high, at least not in the near term. But it doesn't mean that we can't drive it into the shadows so that there are really only small corners of the world where people really suffer from.
Richard says that in the future, he expects pills to be the new form of vaccinations as scientists work to develop new medicine to treat and cure COVID-19.
It's likely that those drugs will be approved over the next few months. I think the future is very bright, and it's going to be here sooner than I think we all expect.
I don't think anything will ever go back to normal.
Life is not life without risk.
All right, let's go out loud to the Thunder Truck, and you can see the very heavy rain down there. Also, if you look very closely, you'll probably see a lightning strike or two. Our photographer, Stephen Boise, is out there. He's on the move, too. Look at that, some very heavy rain. He's right on the cusp. Right there, if you drove just a little bit further to the north toward Calhoun on 75, really, you probably wouldn't even be able to see in front of him with that very heavy rain. Take a look at it on the radar here. I want to show you exactly where Dalesville is. Here's Dalesville right here. This is just northern parts of Bartow County. Now look where he is. He's here. Rain looks pretty heavy on him, but if you just drove just a little bit further up to the north on 75, he'd be running into all this very heavy rain, the numerous lightning strikes associated with what's happening up there. Let me widen this out real quickly to show you exactly what's going on. That's up in Adairsville. We don't have any rain here in Atlanta right now or even to the south. Most of what you see is up here to our far north and off to the west. Even a tornado warning now just to the west of Birmingham. And this red area that you see that's blocked off, that is a tornado watch that does not extend into our state. We do have a severe thunderstorm watch in effect right now. I'm gonna get to that in just a few, but we do not have the tornado watch, nor do we have any warnings out right now. You can see the numerous lightning strikes up here to the north, pointed out where our thunder truck was. All right, just to the north, if you go up toward Calhoun in Gordon County, numerous lightning strikes associated with these storms now extending over just to the west of Rome. Been looking at the Rome camera, still dry there for now, but you can see those ominous clouds. It will be moving in on your own momentarily, and all this will make its way down toward Alpharetta, Atlanta, down through Peachtree City as we head through the rest of the afternoon. And so these storms will be making their way in. Now, those storms will be packing quite a punch as far as the wind speeds go. So far, we've been looking at speeds up to about 40 miles per hour. To get to severe thunderstorms, we need those winds up to about 58, 60 miles per hour. That could happen. We could also see an isolated tornado pop up at any time as well. So we're keeping an eye on it. We want you to keep an eye on it as well. Keep watching us or also download our app. Let's go ahead and put that QR code on the screen right now. Give it some time for people to go ahead and download that. Pull out your phone, put it on photo, and hold it up to that QR code, and it'll download it for you right there. You can get all the warnings right there on your phone. So let's leave that up for just a few for the folks. All right, so the severe thunderstorm watch will remain in effect until 5 o'clock this afternoon. You can see for much of our counties here. Also in the same areas, we'll be looking at the potential for flooding as well. An additional 1 to 3 inches of rainfall is certainly possible, and it's coming down at such a heavy rate that as it begins to hit the ground, it's not enough time for it to run off, so it begins to pile back up. So the roadways will be flooded as well, so be careful if you have to get out. If you don't have to get out this afternoon, go ahead and stay inside. We're tracking a front that's going to continue to push toward the east. As it does, we'll hold on to the threat for those thunderstorms to be around. See this wide area of tan right here from Louisiana stretching into our state? That is a level 3 risk for severe weather. We call it an enhanced risk for severe weather. So our westernmost counties here could experience a little higher level for those tornadoes. tornadoes. In the slight risk area, isolated tornadoes are certainly possible. Can't let your guard down just because you're not in the enhanced area. You're in the slight risk area. Up here to the north, we have that level one, which is a marginal threat where we could see a couple of severe thunderstorms with those winds up to about 60 miles per hour. Hail also a possibility as well. Let's time it out for you hour by hour here. You can see where those storms will make their way down toward Atlanta and then southward once we head through the afternoon. I'd say between now and about 3 o'clock this afternoon, expect that rain to be on us. It will be heavy at times. Those winds will be gusty as well, and we'll have to watch out for any severe thunderstorms or tornado warnings that happen to pop up, and we'll update you on that. It pushes further down to the south as we head toward the 5 o'clock hour. We'll catch a brief break, but we'll also be watching back off to the west as more storms will start to move in. Now, some of these could hold together coming out of Alabama strong enough that could provide tornadoes, especially for our westernmost counties as that pushes further over toward the east. By about 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, things will begin to settle down. We'll see a few scattered showers up to the north, and we'll hold on to those for the morning commute. By the afternoon on Wednesday, things will settle down. We'll get the sunshine back in, and guess what? We'll hold on to that as we head through the rest of the week and into the weekend. In fact, the weekend looks pretty nice as well. Those double digits start to appear on the wasometer once we get toward Thursday. Friday at 10, got an 11 on Saturday with 78 degrees for the high. Going to hold on to the sunshine for Sunday, and then by Monday, the chance for the rain will return to the area. Stay weather ready this afternoon.
Got to get through these next few days, and then we have some sunny days ahead. All right, thanks, Chesley. The American College of OBGYNs recommends that COVID-19 vaccines be offered to mothers who are breastfeeding, and now many online are asking if breastfeeding mothers who are vaccinated can pass antibodies through their breast milk. But what do we know about lactating mothers and the COVID vaccine? Our Verify team is asking the experts.
Verify exists to get you the vetted facts about what you read online. And you've probably heard this one, that breastfeeding mothers who are vaccinated for COVID-19 can pass antibodies through their breast milk. So we're tackling this claim in two parts, with some help from our sources, three breast milk experts, along with some studies on the subject. First, here's question one.
Are there SARS-CoV-2 specific antibodies in human milk? Can we say that with confidence? Yes. Absolutely.
Several studies have found this result already, although we should note that they're not all peer-reviewed just yet.
Take that with a grain of salt. But from the studies that have come out, there's robust antibody response, more so after vaccination and after natural infection and breast milk.
They have only confirmed our feeling that what we would have predicted is that A, it would be safe, and B, there would be transfer of antibodies, and that's what we're seeing in the preliminary data.
So that brings us to our next question. Is there any evidence that these antibodies can protect infants? And at this point, we just don't know for sure. Although two out of our three experts think the answer could be yes, based on what they already know about the medicinal properties of breast milk.
What is the degree of protection? You know, how long does it last? Those are scientific questions that we should explore. But I think it's safe to say that there will be some degree of protection.
If there's something you want us to verify, send us an email. You can also reach out to us on Twitter or on our 11 Alive Facebook page. 1221 right now, Olympic gold, often a solo battle as much as it is a team effort. Coming up, this year's Olympians reflect on just how much they value their teammates as they prepare for the Summer Olympics in Tokyo.
Weather changes can make or break your day. That's why the 11 Alive Storm Trackers are always watching what's coming next, delivering accessible and accurate forecasts that prepare you, not scare you. The Storm Trackers, only on 11 Alive.
COVID-19 is still spreading in Georgia. Now get facts, not fear, at 11alive.com/COVID numbers. Track cases by county using our interactive map and get the latest health department data. Visit 11alive.com/COVID numbers.
Health experts fear we're just at the start of another surge.
Residents here are some of the first seniors to get the vaccine.
This epidemic can come to an end.
We do have a flash flood warning that just popped up here.
And the fallout of this is just beginning.
The bigger questions are the longer legal ramifications.
Morning news should be both informative and fun.
Gone are the days where we're speaking at you. On Morning Rush, we're speaking with you.
So connect with us. Talk to us.
Think of it as a conversation.
Morning Rush weekdays, 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
Quick, open your phone camera right now, aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app.
Winning an Olympic medal can be a long, arduous, sometimes solitary battle, but most any Olympian will admit that it wouldn't mean nearly as much if they didn't have teammates to do it with and for.
I wouldn't do this sport if I had to swim by myself. I'd go crazy. I need people around me who are going to hold me accountable, and you know, I want to do the same for them. I want to hold them accountable.
Dressel's cheering him on, trying to get his sixth gold medal of these championships. Simone Manuel with 10 meters left.
It's essentially, it is a family.
To the wall, it'll be the United States with a new world record.
Being a part of a team is the most magical thing that you can be a part of.
It's like a family because nobody else in the world quite understands the dynamic or everything that goes on, unlike your teammates do.
You know, we're all a family. We all have one common goal that we wanted to uphold, and that's what brings us all together.
I'm close with everyone on the team. Everyone's got each other's back. I mean, at the end of the day, you do it for the guy right next to you.
Of course, you're fighting for the Olympic dream and the Olympic gold medal, but to be honest, it wouldn't mean anything if you weren't on the podium with those women. That's what it's about.
Here in Atlanta, bad weather means bad traffic. A few drops of rain could destroy a commute. But that's where my man Crash Clark comes in. I go street level, he goes next level. Together, we make sure you get to work on time. Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive. Hey, quick, open up your phone camera right now. Aim it at the screen to download 11 Alive's new and improved app. This QR code will take you right to the App Store or Google Play. One simple tap gives you enhanced radar, street level zoom, and severe weather alerts. It's just that easy.
Atlanta roads are my thing. ITP, OTP, Ponce, Piedmont, all the peach trees. Combined with Chesley's street level forecast, that's a lot of tech and experience to help your commute.
Morning Rush, weekdays 5 to 7 on 11 Alive.
We're quite the combo.
Weather changes can make or break your day. That's why the 11 Alive Storm Trackers are always watching what's coming next, delivering accessible and accurate forecasts that prepare you, not scare you. The Storm Trackers, only on 11 Alive.
COVID-19 is still spreading in Georgia. Now get facts, not fear, at 11alive.com/COVID numbers. Track cases by county using our interactive map and get the latest health department data. Visit 11alive.com/COVID numbers.
Health experts fear we're just at the start of another surge.
Residents here are some of the first seniors to get the vaccine.
This epidemic can come to an end.
We do have a flash flood warning that just popped up here.
And the fallout of this is just beginning.
The bigger questions are the longer legal ramifications.
Morning news should be both informative and fun.
Gone are the days where we're speaking at you. On Morning Rush, we're speaking with you.
So connect with us. Talk to us.
Think of it as a conversation.
Morning Rush weekdays, 5 to 7.
All right, here's a live look of Georgia's Rome. I want to show you that very heavy rain coming down, but look at the flags not blowing around all that much. And so we need that wind up for that to be a severe thunderstorm warning up there. But you can see the numerous lightning strikes associated with the storms up there. There's Rome right there. Very heavy rain coming down. All this is making its way down toward the Atlanta metro area, and we'll be arriving here probably between the hours of 1 and 2 o'clock this afternoon. We'll watch for any of these thunderstorms that start to intensify as well. Remember, we do have a severe thunderstorm watch that remains in effect until 5 o'clock this afternoon for all of the highlighted counties. counties here. Winds up to about 60 miles per hour. Hail could be associated with it, and we cannot rule out isolated tornadoes this afternoon. And another system will be making its way toward us later on as we head toward the 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock hour, especially for our westernmost counties where we could see isolated tornadoes. So you need to be watching the skies, watching us, of course, and make sure you get our app so you can get all the alerts right there on your phone so you are not caught off guard by the changing weather that will be taking place in our area for the rest of the afternoon. We're here to keep you and your family safe. Christy, back over to you.
All right, let's end on a good note today. Hundreds of you are talking about this story when 11-year-old Cheyenne's pregnant mom told her she was about to give birth, like now. She had no choice but to step up.
I thought I had a lot more time. I thought I had at least hours at a minimum, not a minute. I had called 911 and I told them like the gist of it. I was like, my mom's having a baby and we're in the bathroom. And they were like, okay, have her lay down.
By that point, it was clear EMTs were not going to make it to the home in Malula, Oregon in time. It would be up to Cheyenne, again, 11 years old. With some guidance from the 911 dispatcher, she was able to deliver her little baby brother, Kobe, safely. There were no complications, and now we're happy to report the family is happy and healthy, and I think I see a future OBGYN nurse. That's the moment. Wow, a very mature 11-year-old jumps into action and adrenaline takes over, and now she can tell her baby brother she literally helped him come into this world. Thanks so much for watching 11 Alive News at Noon. Stay weather aware today and stay safe. We'll see you next time.
Weather changes can make or break your day. That's why the 11 Alive Storm Trackers are always watching what's coming next, delivering accessible and accurate